Today's problem, we are going to deal with some different type of loading apart from what we have already solved. So in this beam, as you can see, so you are supposed to determine the reactions at supports A and B. So if you just have a close examination on this type of beam, it is a overhanging type of beam. So till now, whatever beams we have solved it for simply supported beam. So this is a overhanging beam wherein some portion of the beam is overhanging on either sides. Okay, so if you have a close look on the type of loading, so you have a inclined load at the left end. You have a trapezoidal type of load. Okay, and next you have a movement. So only three types of loadings you have wherein two of them needs to be converted. That is, trapezoidal is to be converted to a point load, and 40 kilonewton inclined load is to be resolved. Now let us draw the free body diagram for this. And we all know that free body diagram consists of actions and reactions, wherein actions are external forces which are acting. So in external forces, this 40 kilonewton force, which is inclined at an angle of 45 degrees with horizontal, it has two components which we are showing here, one horizontal and one vertical. You have a movement which is being shown, which is a clockwise movement of intensity 50 kilonewton meter, which is being shown at the other end. Now next is a trapezoidal load. We have already discussed on how to convert a trapezoidal load into a point load. So your first work is to convert or to divide this trapezoid into a triangle and a UDL first. So if you do that, next what you can do is you can convert that UDL and UVL into a point load. So now in this, what they have done is, so first let us try to divide this. Yes, so we have divided this trapezoidal type of load into a UDL and a UVL. Now let us convert this to a point load. Now as you can see, so to the left end you have an intensity of 20 kilonewton meter, whereas at the right end you have a intensity of 60 kilonewton meter. Now this is being converted into a UDL and UVL. Now if you just have a close look on the UDL, it is seen that UDL spanning is around 3 meters with an intensity 20 kilonewton per meter. So conversion of this would be 20 into 3, which would act exactly at the center. So this 60 kilonewton force, which is being shown here at the center, 1.5 meters from A, which means that it is acting exactly at the center. So 1.5 meters from A. So you have solved for this UDL. Next, coming to UVL. When you come down to UVL, keep in mind the other end you have 60 kilonewton per meter, amongst which 20 kilonewton is being taken by the UDL, and for UVL you are left out only with 40 kilonewton meter on the end. 40 kilonewton meter on the end, and you would calculate the point load for this as half into base into height. Now when you do it as half into base into height, so your equation would be it would be half into base is how much, total 3, half into base into height is 60 minus 20, because 60 minus 20 in the sense 20 is being used by UDL. UDL. So 60 minus 20 is 40. 40. So 40 into 3 is 120. 120 into 0.5 is nothing but 60. So that is what is this 60. Now the next question arises, where is it located? Where is it located? Now you can see that this end, it is a base, whereas this end, it is the apex. And we have discussed regarding the CG of triangle that it always lies 1/3 from the base or 2/3 from the apex. So if you are showing the distance from the apex, it would be 2 divided by 3 into what is the length, that is 3. 2 divided by 3 into 3, which would give you 2 meters. So it is at a distance 2 meters from A, because I'm measuring it from apex. Or if I would have measured it from the base, it would be 1 divided by 3 into 3, which would result as 1 meter. So this is resulted as 2 meters from apex, that is from A, or it is 1 meter from base, that is from B, either of the two. But here we have shown it from the apex only, that is from A, that is 2 meters. Okay, fine. Now the next thing is, you are supposed to replace the supports by reaction. So at point A we have a hinge, whereas at point B we have a roller. We know that hinge has two reactions, that is one vertical and one horizontal. Now see, we have a vertical reaction which is being shown here at point A as RAY, and next a horizontal reaction which is shown as RAX, which is acting leftwards. Now if you just recall back to all the problems what we have solved in before classes, RAX we were actually assuming it to be acting on the right, whereas now we are assuming it to be acting on the left. The reason being, you can see that the horizontal component of 40 kilonewton is acting in the rightward direction. So just to counteract this right force, we are taking the reaction to be acting in the left direction. And that is the reason we have assumed the reaction in the leftward direction. So now our free body diagram is ready. You can proceed with the applying equation of equilibrium. Now let us first decide how many equations of equilibrium we can apply. So we can apply all the 3 equations of equilibrium, because we have all the types of forces which are acting on the free body diagram. That is, there are vertical forces, there is a horizontal forces, as well as there are movement. Okay, so first let us apply sigma fx, that is resolving all the forces in horizontal direction. Rightward forces positive, leftward forces negative. So first let us see how many horizontal forces are there in the diagram. So if you have a close look as to how many horizontal forces you have, 2 horizontal forces, that is one is component of 40 kilonewton and the other one is the reaction. So when you resolve this 40 kilonewton, so horizontal component you get it as a cos component, whereas the vertical you get it as the sine component. So horizontal component is 40 cos 45, and since it is moving to the right, it is taken with the positive sign. Now next is, you have a reaction that is RAX, which is moving to the left, and that is why it is taken with the negative sign. So if you just rearrange the terms here, you will get RAX as 28.284 kilonewton. So horizontal reaction is being calculated as 28.284 kilonewton. Now, next we shall apply equation of equilibrium. That is the second one. That is sigma Fy is equal to zero. Fy is equal to zero. Wherein we are going to consider only the vertical forces. So first let us calculate, or let us count how many total number of vertical forces are there in the diagram. So we have one vertical component, one. You have a reaction here, two. You have 2 point loads, three, four, and five. So you should have five components in sigma Fy. Sigma Fy. So the first one, vertical component of 40 kilonewton, which is acting vertically downwards, and the component is 40 sine 45. It will be with the negative sign. So you can see here 40 sine 45 with the negative sign. 40 sine 45. Next, coming to this reaction RAY, which is acting upwards, so it will be with the positive sign RAY. So you can see that RAY is with the positive sign. Next, 60 kilonewton, which is acting downwards. So there are two vertical forces which are acting downwards, so both will be minus minus. So you have minus 60 as well as minus 60. So the last one is RB, which is acting upwards, so therefore this RB will be with the positive sign, and so it is written with positive sign. So we can see that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 forces. So we have covered all the, or we have included all the five vertical forces. Now if you just rearrange the terms and solve for this, you find that there will be two unknowns, that is RAY and RAB. Thereby they will form a equation, that is RAY plus RB is equal to 148.284 kilonewton. So which can be taken as the equation, Now the next part is, apply another equation of equilibrium, third equation, that is moment, sigma moment. Now, we have already discussed, while applying the moment, we are supposed to apply it at such a point wherein maximum unknowns becomes zero. So preferably we would apply it at point A. Now, before applying the moment, we are supposed to count the total number of forces in the diagram. Next, we are supposed to count the total number of forces passing through the moment center, and finally conclude with how many components will be there in the moment equation. And we all know that while applying moment equation, we have all the clockwise moments to be taken with positive sign and anticlockwise moments to be taken with negative sign. So first let us count all the number of forces which are there in the diagram. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So total 7 forces in the diagram. Amongst these 7, how many passes through moment center A? 3 forces passes through moment center A. Which are those? RAY, RAX, and the other one is horizontal component of 40 kilonewton. So amongst seven, 3 passes through moment center. So we'll be having only 4 components. So these are those 4 components. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So we shall calculate the moment one by one now. So the first one, let us take RB, let us take RB. RB is a vertical force. Vertical force. The distance of this RB from A is 3 meters. Is 3 meters. What type of movement is it causing? It is causing a anti-clockwise movement. So if you can see, it is causing a anti-clockwise movement. So it is taken with the negative sign. It is taken with the negative sign. So RB into 3. RB into 3. Now next is, let us take this 60 kilonewton force. 60 kilonewton force. That is vertical force. Distance to be multiplied horizontal, which is 1.5 meters. What type of movement is it causing with respect to A? It is causing a clockwise movement. A clockwise movement. So it is positive 60 into 1.5. Positive 60 into 1.5. Next, you have another 60 kilonewton force, which is a vertical force again. So the distance of separation is 2 meters from A. So it is 60 into 2 with the positive sign. 60 into 2 with the positive sign. Next, you have a 50 kilonewton movement. 50 kilonewton movement. This 50 kilonewton movement is a clockwise movement. Is a clockwise movement, and thereby it is directly written as plus 50 because it is a movement itself. So you are not supposed to multiply the distance. You are not supposed to multiply the distance. And that is why it is directly written as plus 50. Plus 50. Now next you have the final or the last force, that is vertical component of 40 kilonewton. And vertical component of 40 kilonewton is 40 sine 45. Okay. And since it is a vertical force, distance to be multiplied is obviously a horizontal distance, which is 1 meter. 1 meter. And if you calculate the movement with respect to point A, you see that it is causing a anti-clockwise movement. Okay. And hence it is written as 40 sine 45 into 1 with the negative sign. With the negative sign. So if you happen to solve this total equation, you see that there is only one unknown, that is RB in this equation. And if you solve the equation, you will get an answer for RB, which is 77.238 kilonewton. So you have calculated one more unknown, that is RB. Now, once you get RB, you can substitute the value of RB in equation number 1, that is in this equation, in order to calculate the third unknown, that is RAY. So you substitute the value of RB in equation 1 and you get RAY as 71.046. Okay. Now, the next part is nothing but it is RA on a whole, calculating RA on a whole. So you know that RA is vertically upwards. You know that RAX is horizontally leftwards. So you can always calculate a single force, that is composition of RAY and RAX. So if you just see, okay. So you have one vertical force, that is RAY. Next is you have a horizontal force. You have a horizontal force, that is RAX. So you can always calculate the resultant of both these forces as RA, like this. Okay. So this RA would be nothing but it is square of RAX, square of RAY, which would give you this resultant, that is RA, that is square root of 28.284 square plus 71.046, wherein RA is 78.47.